Adaptations are where biology meets innovation. And over millions of years, bugs have evolved some of the strangest adaptations to survive at least long enough to pass on their genes to the next generation. For them, it's adapt or die. Walking on water? No problem for these intrepid insects. These are water striders. How do they do it? A water strider's legs are blanketed with thousands of tiny water-repellent hairs, which take advantage of the surface tension of the water to stay afloat. Each of its three pairs of legs serves a different function. The front pair is shorter, perfect for grabbing prey. The middle pair are longest, providing most of the power to run after its dinner. And the back pair provide extra thrust, as well as steering and braking. Why bother living on the surface of a pond? Food. By living here, they get access to all sorts of insects that accidentally fall in. Water striders have sharp mouthpieces that they use to pierce prey and suck out the juices. They're a pond's built-in cleaning crew. At a nearby meadow, sheep moth caterpillars have a voracious appetite for leafy greens. But when they get their wings, these moths forego food altogether because they have only one thing on their mind: finding a mate. Most people think of moths as drab, nocturnal insects, but nature loves exceptions. Sheep moths are conspicuously colorful and love a little sunshine. But finding love is not all about a visual show. So how do you find a mate in a massive field? Female sheep moths emit pheromones, an irresistible blend of chemicals she wafts into the air that make her easy to find. Male sheep moths' elaborate feathery antennae help them catch the slightest whiff of a nearby female. And then, like Pepe Le Pew, they follow the trail of fragrance back to its source. Once the moths meet up, they work on making the next generation. This vibrant rendezvous may seem like it would make the moths easy targets for a hungry bird. But their vibrant colors call out to would-be predators, saying, "I taste horrible." Other insects have adapted different tactics to stay off the menu. Ironclad beetles won't meddle in any foot races, but they don't need to. Ironclad beetles are masters of disguise. Unlike some beetles who display flashy colors and a shimmering sheen, ironclad beetles are dark, matte, and covered in bumpy nodules. They blend right into their favorite haunts on shelf fungi and tree bark. And if this camouflage fails and a predator spots the sturdy beetle, it goes with plan B: freeze and play dead. Also called thanatosis, death feigning is a great strategy. A dead beetle isn't all that appetizing to most predators. And if all else fails, ironclad beetles live up to their name. Like a miniature tank, the structure of their hard exoskeleton makes them virtually uncrushable. So they can just hang out until the predator gives up and moves on. Adaptations are nature's strategy of keeping an animal alive with enough pep in its step to reproduce. And bugs have some of the coolest adaptations around.